I've got a customer who lives up in Michigan. Her name is Sandra. And I shouldn't say customer. I should say friend, because all of my customers are my friends. We develop great relationships. Anyway, back in February of 2022, she wanted me to rewire her 201-2. And she and her husband were having a couple of issues getting the lighting assembly out of the machine. So they just wound up sending me the whole bloody thing, as well as a motor from her 15-91. I rewired everything, and I had her 201 anyway, so I just did a service on it. Anywho, when I announced a couple of months back, actually close to 6 months ago now, that I was going to have to cull the herd here a little bit and get rid of some machines, she's like, ooh, I need a 99 or a 99K. And I'm like, great, I've got a machine for you. Well, as we know, issues, things came up and things got pushed back a little bit. Well, I'm working on a 99K for Sandra right now. And is she going to be gorgeous? This is going to be a series. This is the first episode where we're going to disassemble it and take a look at what the machine needs. I'm not going to tell you in the intro here how old this 99 is, but suffice it to say, she's good. She's an oldie. She's in a bentwood case. She has been electrified. Let's put it that way. She's pre-electric singers. And we're going to bring her up to date on a couple of things. We will update a couple of systems on her. But I think you're going to like it. And this first episode is just the disassembly and the cleaning of the body. The next episode we will go through, we will clean all the internals and the bottom end parts. Then we'll do an episode where we do the reassembly of those parts. Then an episode where we rewire her and test stitch and everything. So yeah, it's going to be interesting. It's going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to get this done over the next couple of weeks too. I'm not going to stretch this out. This is going to be bang, 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 bang. This is also going to be part of Sunday morning quickies. This is going to be I need to get this this machine shipped kind of thing. But I'm doing video all at once on it. So kick back, grab a cup of coffee. You're going to like this one. Okay. What we have here is a Singer 99K that dates back to 1918. So, yeah, January or February time frame of 1918 is when this serial number was allocated. This is exactly as I got it. This is the 99K I was telling you about in the last video with the 201. This is one I got from Tony up in Connecticut. It's an as-found condition. Somebody had added a Singer BT7 motor to it, which that's going to get worked on. There's a light assembly. This, too, will have to be serviced and worked on. The bobbin winder is in pieces, but all of the pieces seem to be here, albeit a bit rusty. What I'm seeing now as far as... Oh, that actually moves. Very good. What I'm seeing as far as missing parts so far just appears to be the discs for the upper thread tension. As far as I... Oh, there's a screw missing here on the end plate. I hope that's not broken off. If it is, it's going to be a challenge. Let me get these parts off into a bin so they don't get lost. In the end cap, it's another screw that goes to something. We'll have to figure that out. Put that in the bin. There's a bunch of attachments in here. And, there is a top to the bentwood case, which Tony had a strap on to hold it in place. I do have a, the screw is broken off here. Hold on. Let me swing this around. This lower screw is broken, but I'm pretty sure that that can be extracted. But anyway, I have a key to the case, and the case latch actually does work. Tony did not have that. I actually made a key that will work on this. Let's take a look a little deeper. Let's get this needle off here. I don't really feel like stabbing myself with something of questionable vintage. And all right, yeah, the needle plate is, it might polish up. The bobbin case area has a nice amount of schmoo in there. We'll get to that eventually. But yeah, she's got a few issues. Nothing seemingly insurmountable. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to take her out of the case. We're going to get her just on the bench as it is. We're going to strip her down to her component parts. And then we're going to start the resurrection. This particular machine is going to viewer Sandra. I promised her a nice 99 or 99K. This is the machine. It is definitely going to... The decals seem to be in pretty good shape. So this is going to be a nice machine when it's done. All right. Let me get her out of the base, and we'll get started. All right, I've got another container that I'm just going to put small parts in here. And we're going to start stripping her down. Fortunately, 99s are amongst my favorites to work on. And I know them pretty much like the back of my hand. So, while some may kind of cringe that I'm just throwing parts, seemingly throwing parts willy-nilly into a bin. When we're done, there won't be anything left over. All right. That piece off. There we go. It's loosened up. And I made a conscientious effort to clean off my bench recently. I'm going to try to keep it cleaner, and I've moved some tools around, like my small screwdriver rack I moved to the back here. It used to be off to the side, over to the right. All right, let's see what kind of... Oh, yes! Hold on. Let me zoom in on that. This is the kind of stuff I love! Hold on. Get that off of there. Look at that! Let's get a pointer in here and remove felt. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? This is what I like to see. This means this machine was used. Yeah, baby. It's all fluff. Nothing insurmountable. But that's good news. That's really a good sign. Get the worst of this out. Not even enough to make a sweater for a New York City subway rat. Not that bad. But it's all coming out anyway. All right. Okay. Yeah. What the? Actually, no. Those are complete discs. Oh my god. This is a little different than what I'm used to seeing. This is actually a complete upper thread tension unit. It just looks different because it's so early. These are actually all the parts. I was mistaken. Wow. Okay. I've never took one apart that was this old. This is definitely the oldest of the 99s that I have worked on. I've worked on machines older than this. Yeah, this is very different here. I've worked on machines that were older, but not a 99 that was older. Well, I cannot wait to get this one in condition. And the rust. There it goes, now it's sliding down. There's a lot of crud on this. Oops, wrong size. Breaking through the schmoo. Problem is there's over 100 years of crud on this, and it doesn't necessarily want to come off super easy. So we're going to let that soak for a little bit. In the interim, we'll take some other parts off of it. That's on incorrectly. The washer's backwards on this. So we'll just... take the washer out for the moment. Take the balance wheel off. All right. Not bad. Let's get in the back here. I can't get that one in there. And we'll see if we can get the... There we go. Yuck. That's too big. Not gonna fit on that. All right, let's get a little shmoo remover on there. Okay. In the meantime, let's see how this is coming along. Oh, that's going to come right out now. There we go. Now it's out. That's disgusting. Let's work on the bottom end first while we're waiting for that stuff to de-shmooify. Dog. All right, I need 3/8. Loosen that up just a touch. I meant for that to happen. Magnet on a stick. Retrieval tool. Alright, there we go. Yeah, this stuff is nasty. And I'm seeing these are smaller. These are smaller sized pivots on the bottom, or at least they appear to be smaller. I could be wrong. That certainly doesn't look 9/16. Oh, it is 9/16. Okay. It's an optical delusion. Children's poem. Ooey gooey was a worm, a mighty worm was he. He sat upon the railroad tracks, the train he did not see. Yeah, well, this is, in fact, ooey gooey. I know what it looks like. I can't describe what it feels like. It's got a very unique feel to it. This shmoo, this level of shmoo, has a unique feel. And it is difficult to describe. let's take this one off first. Yeah, don't stab yourself, Bob. All right. Bringing out the artillery. Crack that right free. Why hurt yourself if you don't have to? All right, that is too tight. We will loosen that up. I must confess, it took me a while before I would allow myself to take power tools like my Milwaukee impact gun to a sewing machine, but once I decided that enough was enough with hurting myself and stabbing myself with screwdrivers, it just makes it so much faster. All right, we need to get, look at all this good stuff. A lot of crap in there. All right, let's get the, get this back out of the way. Hopefully we won't need it anymore. And although we might. Yep, one more shot. One more shot. With the impact gun. There it goes, that loosened it. Did it. Yeah, not really. Problem is that these are straight fasteners. And keeping these under control can be a pain. So, I'm going to go vertically to get more control. There we go. You gonna be that much of a pain in the neck? All right, we'll try this again. You're gonna spin free, but you're not gonna come out of the hole. There you go. Out, and there's the washer, which went flying. It chowdered a little bit, but I'll be able to fix that, no problem. And let's get the, with 99s, these things are always a little bit more of a challenge getting them in and out, especially with over 100 years of crud on them. Come on, baby. Pop to the side. There you go. And magnet on the stick. Extract this out the top. Ooh, that took the bearing with it. Oh, it's because the bearing's rusted onto it. Here comes the fork. Okay. All right. There we go. And we can extract this. And then what's left is the bobbin case positioning bracket and the bobbin case. And the last thing we'll fight to get out will be the needle bar. Because, of course, it's going to be a pain in the neck. For those who are uninitiated, the Model 99 was originally something that that was produced out of the Kilboe plant. Oh, look at this. Look at that. Isn't that lovely? Before there were American-made 99s, there were Scottish-made 99s. They started making them in Kilboe, I believe, in 1911. And it wasn't until quite a few years later that they started making them in the plant in New Jersey. I don't think Singer thought that they were going to catch on. Boy, was Singer wrong about that, if that was what their thinking was. Because they made a bunch of these for many, many years. And as I have made abundantly clear on this channel in the past, I do prefer these over the featherweight. There we go. All right. Oh, look at all the crud. Look at that. Yeah, baby. We got it packed in there. It's glued in there, too. All right. We got something to work on. All right. Parts out of the way. Now, let's turn our attention back to this needle bar and see if we can get that to cooperate. There it goes. I heard a crack. That tells me that cracked free. Yes, it did. See, that's the beauty of having a little bit of patience and a lot of croil. And I suspect that might even be a little bit bent. But we're going to find out in a couple minutes. Actually, let's find out right now. That might be all right. We'll clean that out, and then we'll try dropping the needle bar back through once we get everything clean here. But all right. Well, when it comes time, we'll do the polishing on that. In the interim, let's see if we can get that back out. Yep, now it's coming. Give the croil a chance to do its job, and the croil does just that. And no, Cano, the makers of croil, are not a sponsor. I just love this stuff. And I know a lot of people don't. A lot of people say it smells bad, but hey. Oh, look at that. Look at the varnish on that. That is old oil that has turned to schmoo. All right. Yeah, let's knock these pins out and extract the fork, and we'll extract the lifter. Actually, before we do that, loosen this and pull the thread guide. Yeah, this machine is definitely grungy. Thread guide in there. I'm going to put this screw back for the moment. We'll take it out again and clean it later. Make it pretty. I just don't want to lose it. Correction. What I thought was a broken off screw here, which is where there normally would be a screw, was actually the end of the pin that holds the transfer over. On this machine, they have the pin, the end of the pin gets exposed through the end of the plate here, and that's what holds it vertically, and then that screw tightens it up. This is an early version, what can I say? All right, now I need to get this pin driven out. I need to find my small punches. That should do it. Get a little bit more light on that. I can see what I'm doing. Trying to make this so you guys can see what I'm doing as well. There we go. Pin is out. Arm is out. There we are. And sometimes, and I hate to say this, but sometimes making it so you guys can see what I'm doing makes it harder for me to do what I'm doing, but I think everybody knows that already. So, let me get some, clear the decks here. Now, that's as far apart as this machine is going to come, with one exception. Because this machine is going to be shipped, I'm going to take out this pressed-in pin, and I'll be tapping the top of the machine and putting in a screw in. So, let me grip this ever so gingerly and crack it loose. There we go. And it's out. Had that a little tight. It didn't even mar it up. Cool. Alright. So, actually, hold on. Let's do a little bit more. Let's take this thread guide off. And we will take out this spring and screw. Now that's in there. All right. So, we now have a carcass. I'm not going to take that apart any further. And I'll take that screw off later and clean it. This, I think, is as far apart as we're going to go. So let's see how well she cleans up. Do an initial cleaning of the body, just to get a ballpark idea of what we're going to be working with. So, put some tools away here. Oh gosh, I have never been this clean and organized on my bench. Okay, I know. Though there are those amongst you who are going, what do you mean clean and organized, Bob? That's a nightmare. All right. Let's see what she does. All right, I need to get something. I have learned that this is going to sling stuff everywhere. So I'm going to clear the decks here a little bit more. I'm going to get some old towels and cover tools up, and I'll be right back. just had a customer call with a Kenmore. Now I can't get very close to the edges with this. I'm gonna have to get into the corners by hand. How it's going to come up. Because this is such a small machine, there's a lot of this I'm going to have to do by hand. I'm not going to be able to get to the machine to it with the machine. But the more I can get with the machine, the less time I'm going to have to sit there being the 240-pound gorilla. Oh. I can see out the window. There's some new cats in the neighborhood that are hanging out on our patio. And if I trash the decals on this, I can always re-decal it, but I'm trying to avoid that. Just trying to get the grime off. All right, you can see that side is pretty dead. That side's looking a lot better. Actually, you can tell better with the arm. Yeah, this is gonna clean it up really well. I won't bore you with all of this. So I'm just gonna continue the cleaning process and we'll come back when the body's clean. Well, here's a progress report. She's coming along quite nicely, as you can see. I still got a ways to go, but that's a big improvement over what she was. I think everybody will agree with that. So, I'll be back with more. Guys, I didn't put much time into this at all, getting the grime off. There's still a little bit down here along the edges that I can't get with the machine that I have to do by hand. But, I'm going to call this polished at the moment. There's some other cleanup work, obviously, that needs to be done, especially in here. There's a bunch of stuff where I have to do some wire wheeling. I got to do some cleaning here. And I will go over the bed of this machine one more time and get some more wax on it. But you saw what it looked like when I started taking this apart. This was butt ugly. And you saw what I was just able to do. This is pretty freaking amazing. So, anyway, yeah. We're going to continue the march on getting this machine ready to go for Sandra. Next episode of this, we'll be cleaning the interior parts. That'll do this for now. Next video will be cleaning the interior. And then, in the meantime, I will finish detailing this. I don't need to show that. And then, we'll get all the parts cleaned in the next episode. And then we will spend an episode assembling her and maybe another episode doing, the final testing. We'll definitely do something, an episode where we'll go through the wiring as well. But, yeah. All I can say is, wow. Well, there you have it. So much for episode 1 of a 99 for Sandra. Thank you all so much for watching, and we will see you on the next one.